Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll talk about AutoVacuum, that tuple's not yet removable, and what the X-Men horizon in Postgres does. We'll start with an old blog post back from 2018. So the reason I looked at this blog post again is because it was talking about a production issue that a friend ran into last week. And what that friend had mentioned is that they encountered this that tuple's not yet removable problem, and it quite puzzled them. We'll start looking at this blog post first, which gives a bit of a background of what that problem means. So in this situation, the team at Precox encountered a problem with their Amazon RDS database. They saw that really simple queries kept taking a really long time. Queries that were expected to finish fast took 5 minutes. The whole system was showing slowdowns. They suspected there is a problem with vacuuming. And so they looked at PGSet activity, and they saw that one of their tables, the opportunities table, was vacuuming a lot. Every 10 minutes, that table was being vacuumed. And when they turned on more logging, they also learned that that vacuum itself took 10 minutes. The vacuum ran for 10 minutes and then finished, but then it started again a new vacuum. So it kept continuously vacuuming the exact same opportunities table. What AutoVacuum is supposed to do is that it avoids tables growing unnecessarily. If a table did not have AutoVacuum running, it will have to keep growing to store new data somewhere, because if data is being deleted, then it cannot be reused unless AutoVacuum runs. The second good best practice that they reference here is that if your AutoVacuum takes a long time, it's oftentimes because it doesn't run often enough. So running AutoVacuum more often is generally a good thing if the problem is that your vacuum runs too long. They did tune various AutoVacuum settings, but what they realized is it didn't work at all. It did not help. Changing all these settings did not resolve their issue. Database was still slow, and they still had this continuously running AutoVacuum on that one table. Now, they pulled in some additional help, and they looked at the AutoVacuum log output. When you have AutoVacuum problems, look at the logs. They can tell you a lot. In this particular case, they did notice that AutoVacuum couldn't remove that tuples while it was working. There is a specific section where it says how many tuples were removed, how many tuples are remaining in the table. Tuples are kind of like rows, you could say, row versions. And then 26,000 tuples are dead, but are not yet removable. Zero removed means AutoVacuum didn't do anything really. Now, what does that mean, not yet removable? Not yet removable means that AutoVacuum was not able to clean it up because the data that the tuple contained was still visible to an open transaction. So there was still something open in the system that could have looked at that tuple. Even though it was deleted, there was still something that had a right to look at the tuple. In this particular situation, what they found was that the ORM, Active Record, kept some really long operations running in a transaction. Their application code contained long blocks in Ruby, essentially, and they removed some of them or reduced the length of these transactions. They also reduced the number of updates, and both of these changes in this situation resolved the problem. Now, what they did in this blog post with solving log running transactions doesn't always help. And when I was talking with a friend of mine about their production issue, they actually said that they followed all these guidelines, but they still didn't have vacuum running successfully. Now, there's this other blog post by Lawrence from CyberTech that goes into more details of why AutoVacuum cannot remove dead rows from a table. Funnily enough, it's also from 2018. Apparently, it's a good year for Postgres blog posts. In this blog post, he describes that row versions cannot be removed yet. Here in Vacuum Verbose, it's actually more visible with the oldest X-Men showing. You can go look for which object in the system is holding back the vacuum. The reason that the vacuum cannot remove those rows, as mentioned earlier, is because it could still be that that process that has that old X-Men still has the rights to see those tuples until that operation finishes. This is what you call the X-Men horizon. That's essentially the oldest transaction ID that's still running that has rights to see these tuples, so they can't be removed. There are three things that can hold back transactions. The first thing is long-running transactions. Long-running transaction keeps open the X-Men horizon from transaction start. If you run this query, that helps you find these long-running transactions. Second thing, and I've personally had forgotten that this was a thing, is that replication slots also hold back the X-Men horizon. You wouldn't see it if you look at Peach's activity, but you would have to check Peach's replication slots, and that's going to show you the X-Men for that specific replication slot. This replication slot is the reason why the X-Men horizon cannot advance. And this was actually a problem that that friend of mine had, is they had a leftover replication slot from their HA tooling, and that's why it wasn't successfully auto-vacuuming the tables. There's also a situation with prepared transactions. If you use two-phase commit, it's really important to clean up prepared transactions, either commit them or roll them back, because if you're left open, then day two can hold back the X-Men horizon and stop auto-vacuum. Remember those three things. If you have problems with auto-vacuum and that tuple is not yet removable, make sure to check your longer transactions, your replication slots, and your prepared transactions. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to hear about new episodes. I'll talk to you next week.